Welcome to a preview of the Capstone course, EDU 690, and an overview of this course, EDU 683. It is very important that you understand the big picture of the Capstone project, as you will begin the process in this course. The requirements for EDU 690, the final capstone for your degree, include completed e-portfolio, which you will begin in this course. In EDU 690, your e-portfolio must include your philosophy of education statement, your resume, and artifacts from all of your courses in the Southern New Hampshire University degree program. You must also complete a semester-long curriculum, which you will begin in EDU 683. Another requirement is a presentation, which will be directed to a school board or education audience that already has a copy of your full curriculum design. You will need to explain your decision-making process, backed by data and research. This will be your opportunity to show your expertise in curriculum design. Now that you know what will be expected of you in the Capstone course, let's look at the requirements in EDU 683. Your first assignment, 1.3, is to select an achievement gap occurring in current educational settings. This does not have to be within your own classroom or school district. The next assignment is 2.1, the annotated bibliography, followed by the literature review, 4.2. After you have completed the research process, you will design a semester-long curriculum outline, assignment 6.2. In Module 10, you will begin the e-portfolio. In this course, you need only submit 3 pages: the philosophy of education statement, completed in assignment 7.2, your resume, and the artifacts page. There are some things to remember as you select the achievement gap you will address. First, you will need to identify a problem in today's classrooms. In your achievement gap statement, you need to compare 2 different groups. For instance, students from a low socioeconomic level and their peers from higher socioeconomic levels. Then, add the subject and grade level that you will address in your curriculum units. For example, the achievement gap addressed in this project focuses on reading performance between 5th grade students from a low socioeconomic level and their peers from higher socioeconomic levels. Finally, you need to select a gap that is universal or global, where there is adequate research available. You will then identify strategies to bridge your achievement gap. This will be the center thrust in your curriculum design. Ask yourself, what strategies can you incorporate into your curriculum units to bridge the gap? In assignment 2.1, you will compile research in an annotated bibliography. Some of this research will support the existence of the achievement gap. Other sources will suggest instructional or assessment strategies that will bridge the gap. The assignment requires 3 to 5 scholarly sources. I suggest you look first for peer-reviewed articles in professional education journals. The annotated bibliography should be written in a citation and annotation format. The next research assignment will be a literature review. Again, the resources should be peer-reviewed or scholarly sources. you need to include the resources in the bibliography and add additional research, so you have a total of 8 to 10 sources. The literature review should be in a narrative format. This is a different type of report than the bibliography. Make sure you check the course announcements for examples of these research papers. For the literature review, you will need to find research to support the existence of the achievement gap. Other sources will suggest instructional or assessment strategies that will bridge the gap. You are looking for research sources that offer specific strategies that can be used within your curriculum units. You may have a couple of sources that offer other influences outside of the curriculum, but do not focus on these factors. Most educators cannot change a family's income level or a school's budget, even though these factors often affect the gap. The curriculum outline should be a detailed account of each question posed in the template. Please use the EDU 683 UBD template. Do not use any other Understanding by Design templates from other sources or former courses. This curriculum must be a semester long. Your semester will most likely be 12 to 18 weeks long, and you can only have a maximum of 3 units. However, only 2 units are required in this course. You will be required to write a single research statement for certain strategies used in your curriculum. These statements need to be correctly cited in APA style, 7th edition. Your curriculum must be easily replicated, as you will be trying to convince a school board to adopt your curriculum in their schools. I know the questions in the UBD template indicate a personal response, but you cannot use first-person pronouns in your curriculum. If you remember that you are writing this curriculum for other teachers to use, it will be easier to stay away from first-person responses. There are 2 other assignments in EDU 683. You will refine your educational philosophy created in former Southern New Hampshire University courses. There is a 500-word limit that will be enforced. This does not count the title page or references, so use the review link in Microsoft Word to calculate the word count in your text. As in the curriculum, the philosophy cannot be in the first person tense. Remember that the educational philosophy will be a narrative without subtitles or lists. There are also specific categories that must be addressed in your personal philosophy. You will need to explain your beliefs on technology, assessment, and how to stay up to date with current educational instructional practices. In assignment 10.2, you will be asked to share your e-portfolio with me. In this course, you only need to include 3 pages. There will be a welcome page with a short personal introduction and your educational philosophy statement. The next page will contain your resume. And finally, you will create an artifacts page, where you will list 3 to 4 categories based upon Standard 4 of the Professional Standards for Educational Leaders. Under each category, you will include 1 completed assignment from this course and/or previous Southern New Hampshire University courses. There should also be a short rationale as why this artifact belongs in the selected category. Here are some important reminders to help you be successful in this course. Read all rubric guidelines. This includes the directions and the actual rubric categories. You will notice that in the discussions, the rubric has fewer elements and higher value than in some of your previous courses. The three major categories, professional applications, organization, and metacognition, are each worth 30 points. This means that if you do not meet expectations in one of these areas, you will be docked 30 points, resulting in a failing grade. Please address the prompt in your initial post and responses. Also required is at least one research citation in each initial post. Please review all announcements, as I offer specific guidance and resources for every assignment. There will also be an example for each assignment that you can use as a model for the format of your work. Make sure you use APA Style 7th edition in all posts and assignments. Did you know if you were to have points subtracted in every assignment just in writing mechanics, the points would mount up to 119 points, and there are only 100 points between each grade level. Please edit your writing carefully. Don't forget to read and implement all feedback, especially in each milestone. There will be feedback in the general comments, the rubric, and turn it in markups on your document. I do compare assignments to make sure that you have made the suggested changes. If you have any questions about this information or your project plans, don't hesitate to contact me. You can reach me through my Southern New Hampshire University email. Or if you would rather speak with me, just send me an email to arrange a time for a Zoom meeting or a phone call. When you consider contacting me in person, please remember that I live in Central Time. Thank you for listening as we looked at the big picture in your capstone requirements.